Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this video, we will be discussing the two main classification schemes for joints. So the two ways to classify joints are structurally, which is where we will spend the majority of the rest of our time discussing joints, as well as functionally, which we will introduce here and will be a much smaller focus in subsequent videos. We will also discuss the term ligament, or ligaments, if we're talking plural, as these are so important to joints overall, and these often play a role in how we actually describe a joint. So as we mentioned, the two major ways to describe joints are structurally, which will describe the tissues that will actually connect the bones. So kind of the key here is what tissues are connecting the bones and where it's located. Remember, there will be some connective tissues between the bones always. Bones don't actually touch. There will also be functional classifications. And these are really more describing the degree of movement permitted at a joint. So of the functional classifications, there are three types. The joints that are immovable, so no movement whatsoever, these are synarthroses. An amphiarthrosis is a slightly movable joint. And when I say slightly movable, I definitely mean that. Sometimes the movement is so slight that it's not even perceivable. And lastly, typically when we think of a joint, we are thinking of diarthrotic joints, which are freely movable. All synovial joints, which is a structural classification, are diarthrotic. Diarthroses come in a variety of shapes and permit many different types of movement and to varying degrees. In terms of structural classifications, there are two basic ways that bones will connect with one another to form joints. The first is the simplest. These are the simplest. The bones will be attached to one another by a solid sheet, and that's key here, a solid sheet of connective tissue, so no space between the bones. So you can see that really well here. You're going to have a bone here, and in between you have a solid sheet of connective tissue that's actually connecting the bones. What can differ in this classification scheme is the type of connective tissue which makes up the connections. Is it going to be dense, irregular connective tissue like you have in fibrous joints? Or is it going to be cartilage like you have in cartilaginous joints? The other way that joints form is a bit more complex, but it's actually the most common type. And this has bones being joined by a connective tissue capsule, which you can see on the outer ends of the bone. And so that's what is actually connecting the bones. And then in the middle, there will be this lubricated cavity, which is not composed of a sheet of connective tissue. It's in essence a slight space between the bones, so not that solid sheet of connective tissue. And this allows more possibilities for movement, and these types of joints are called synovial joints, which is where we are going to spend the majority of our time in our joint discussions. Each one of these structural categories, fibrous, cartilaginous, and synovial, will have their own video, so we will talk in more details there. But before we finish here, let's talk a little bit about ligaments. Ligaments are going to connect bone to bone, which is different from tendons. Tendons will connect muscle to bone. And ligaments are composed of dense regular or dense irregular connective tissue. Depending on the source, you may see different things. But what they look like and where they are located can vary wildly and widely. And ligaments are identified, how they're identified can vary quite a bit by discipline, and sometimes even within a discipline. For our purposes, we are going to describe ligaments that actually bind the bone. So what we saw here with that sutural ligament. So what is actually binding the bones, those solid sheets of connective tissue between the bones, those will be intrinsic ligaments. And those that are playing a supportive role, Those will be referred to as extrinsic, and these are particularly important with synovial joints. Sometimes these ligaments can be located as part of an articular capsule, or even within an articular capsule, and these are often referred to as capsular or intracapsular, dependent on their location. And sometimes the ligaments are completely separate from the articular capsule, but will support the joint overall and will help prevent unwanted movements. And those are referred to as extracapsular. So definitely more to come on ligaments. We will discuss specific ligaments with each joint, each of the main joints that we will discuss later on. All right, so that was some good fun in introducing joints, and let's review a concept regarding those functional classifications. So question, functionally, I have it right there in the question stem. Functionally, a freely movable joint is described as what? A, an amphiarthrosis, B, a diarthrosis, or C, a synarthrosis. Pause the video if needed. And when ready, I hope you have landed on B, diarthrosis being the correct answer. Amphiarthroses are very slightly movable, but certainly not described as freely movable, whereas a synarthrosis is immovable, so definitely not freely movable. All synovial joints will be diarthrotic or freely movable, so that relationship between free movement and synovial joints is a really important one. That is where we get those typical movements of the body that we often think of. All right, so that is it for these concepts. Thank you for your time and attention here, and have a great rest of your day.